The seat adjustment is set by putting the pivot bolt into one of the three holes that are in a vertical line next to the yellow triangle. You'll see here we lift up and align the top hole with the inside threaded hole. That's aligned right now. That's the 17-inch setting. Then we'll raise up a little higher for the middle hole. That's aligned now for the 18-inch setting. And then a little bit higher will get you the 19-inch setting. Here's the pivot bolt and a nylock nut that goes on the inside. The nylock nut has a nylon insert that you can see is a blue colored. The nylock nut also acts as a jam nut because the hole for the pivot bolt is threaded. Here you can see the pivot bolt has been inserted into the uppermost hole, which provides for the lowest seat height of 17 inches from the floor. Here you can see the two lock nuts. You'll have to use the open-end wrench to tighten them because there's not room for a socket or the box end of the combination wrench. Next, we'll need to set the seat inclination by a combination of one of these two non-threaded holes with one of these two threaded holes. And here we have the seat plate secured in position. We have this bolt is in the upper hole of the seat plate, and it is in the lower hole of the black strut. This provides a level seat at 17 inches from the floor. Once you have all of the bolts tightened, go ahead and run the seat recline into the full recline position and then back down just to make sure that everything is running smoothly. It's also very important to make sure that the seat recline is in the full down position when setting the inclination bolts. And there's full recline position. Everything sounds smooth and operates as it should. If you have an extra joystick, you can plug it in and operate it that way, or you can use a Arnet extension cable and plug it into your joystick that's still on your seat frame.